Hi everyone. Already we completed algebra some part, linear equations in two variables, space of linear equations in two variables. Now we are coming to polynomials. Till now, if you didn't subscribe my channel, please subscribe my channel. Thank you. So here polynomials. Polynomials means an algebraic expression. Polynomial is also an algebraic expression in which the variables involved have only non-negative integral powers. Non-negative means only positive, and integers then only powers is called a polynomial. Here this is algebraic expression, this is algebraic expression, this is also algebraic expression. So no need to write zero, this is equation. So expression, algebraic expression. All these are algebraic expressions, but in this here its power is non-negative, means positive integer 2, and here power 1. All powers are variables, powers variable unde powers are non-negative integers. So this is called polynomial. This is a polynomial. Now here it's a variable power 1, here y it's power 1, here z it's power 1. All powers are variable powers are non-negative integers. So this is also a polynomial. But if you come here 2 by x plus 3y plus 3. Here y power is 1. But here we have 2 by x. 2 by x means we can write it as 2 into 1 by x. 1 by x become 2 into x power minus 1. 2 by x become 2 into x power minus 1. Means here x power is negative. But we need non-negative. Here we have negative power. So this is not. If at least one term has negative power, then it is not a polynomial. This we can say as algebraic expression. But in this algebraic expression, these three are algebraic expressions, but these two are polynomials. This is not a polynomial. And you can observe under root of, square root of x means x power 1 by 2. X power 1 by 2 means this is positive, okay. But this is not an integer. Integers, integers means one non-negative integers. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like so on. Non-negative integers. Simply we can say natural numbers. Natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. If power is only natural numbers, then only we can say that algebraic expression is a polynomial. Here, degree of a polynomial. Already we studied in a degree of algebraic expression. Same here. Degree means degree of a polynomial, means already we studied in an algebraic expression. So here power of variable 1, 1, we have to add 2. So this term degree is 2, this term degree is 2, this term degree is 1, and this term numeral its degree is 0. So here highest degree of this total terms is 2. Highest degree is only the degree of this total polynomial. Here highest degree is 3, 2, 1, 0. Highest degree is 3. So this polynomial's degree is 3. This polynomial 1, 1, 1 power 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 3. So it's a degree 3, it's a degree 2, it's a degree 2, 2, 2. But highest is 3. So this polynomial's degree is 3. It's 18, and root of x means x power 1 by 2 plus 2y. Here degree is 1, highest, but this is a algebraic expression. This is not a polynomial. This is not a polynomial. Why? Because this is not integer. If we have non-negative integer, then only we can say that is a polynomial. So this is not a polynomial. We can say this as a algebraic expression. Next, polynomials. So different polynomials we have here. Zero polynomial. Zero polynomial means only zero. The number zero. Then that is called zero polynomial. its degree is not defined. Not defined. Only zero. If you have only zero, that is called zero polynomial. Its degree not defined. Next, constant polynomial. Constant polynomial means you can take minus 1, 2, 1 by 2, etc. Anything, any number, numeral. If you take any numeral, that is called constant polynomial. Here variable power is 0. So, degree is 0. Linear polynomial. Linear means number 1. If degree of the polynomial is 1, that is called linear polynomial. Here degree is 1. Quadratic polynomial. Quadratic means if degree is 2, that is called quadratic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. If degree is 3, that is called cubic polynomial. Here degree is 2 plus 1, 3. And here x cube, degree is 3. If the degree of a polynomial is 3, then that is called as cubic polynomial. These are different types of polynomials. Already in algebraic expressions, we learnt this. In this polynomial also same. By depending on number of terms, also we can name polynomials. If number of terms is 1, here we have only one term, 3x, then that is called monomial. If we have 2, number of terms 2, their degree, if degree is 2, then we call it as quadratic polynomial. Here, if terms 2, this is called binomial. You should be know the difference between terms and degree. If terms are 3, 1, 2, 3, 3 terms, trinomial. If more than 3 or more than 1, that is called multinomial. If this depends on number of terms, first I told that linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial, those depends on degree of the polynomial. Zero of a polynomial. Zero means simply we can say it's a solution. Means here polynomial p of x is equal to x plus 2. By substituting which value at x, you will get p of x is equal to 0. By substituting which value at this x, we will get p of x is equal to 0. That x value is called as 0 of this polynomial. Simply, x plus 2 is equal to 0. If you transpose that plus 2, that become minus 2. X is equal to minus 2. Means, this total should be 0. At which value of x we will get 0? X is equal to minus 2. When x is equal to minus 2, then we will get 0. So, this minus 2, x is equal to minus 2 is the 0 of this polynomial. Division of a polynomial. So, one polynomial dividing with another polynomial. Here, simple division. 2x square plus 1, we are dividing with x plus 1. Here we have x, but we need 2x square. If you multiply this x with 2x, x into 2x, we will get 2x square. So, 2x square. For this, here we have 2x square. To get 2x square, we should multiply x with 2x. But here we have 1 also. So, with this 1 also, we have to multiply. Plus 1 into 2x is 2x. 2x. X plus 1 multiplied with 2x. We get 2x square plus 2x. Subtract this. Subtract means plus become minus. This plus become minus. Plus 2x square minus 2x square gets cancelled. Here we have plus 1 minus 2x. Plus 1 minus 2x. Next, here we have x. 2x. But here we have x. So, to get minus 2x, we should multiply this x with minus 2. This x should multiply with minus 2. Then we get minus 2x. X terms, I am writing under x term. It x term, but x term kidane raaskuntunna. Next, but here we have plus 1. Plus 1 also should multiply with minus 2. So, plus into minus, minus 1, 2s are 2. So, first we have to check for x terms. We get, but 1 also should multiply with that minus 2, na? So, that's why I multiplied. Here, we have to subtract. When we are subtracting, minus become plus. Minus become plus. Minus 2x, plus 2x gets cancelled. 1 plus 2, 3. This is remainder. We cannot, again, we cannot multiply with this x plus 1. If we multiply with this x plus 1, again we will get x terms. But we don't have any x term. Here we have only constant. So here, remainder is 3. Here, remainder for this. If you multiply 2x square plus 1 with x plus 1, we will get remainder 3. Except dividing with that, simply we can do this like this. X plus 1, we have to divide this with x plus 1. So that I am writing as x plus 1 is equal to 0. Then we will get, if you transpose this plus 1 that side, it becomes minus 1. X is equal to minus 1. Just to substitute in this, this take as p of x is equal to 2x square plus 1. Then except that x we are taking minus 1, p of minus 1. So substitute here, except that x, substitute minus 1. Minus 1 whole square plus 1. Minus 1 whole square is minus 1 into minus 1, 1 square, 1 plus 1. So 2 into 1, 2 plus 1. That is equal to 3. This is only the remainder, p of minus 1. When we divided 2x square plus 1 with x plus 1, we got the same remainder 3. Except dividing with like that, by simply x plus, take x plus 1 is equal to 0, then we will get the x value. Substitute that x value in this polynomial. Simply you will get the remainder. This is only remainder theorem. Very important, this is remainder theorem. Remainder theorem is, if you want to divide any polynomial p of x with any g of x. If you want to divide any polynomial with p of x with any other polynomial g of x, then the zero of this polynomial, if you substitute in p of x, you will get the remainder. Remainder theorem, simply. If p of x is a polynomial, if p of x is divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, then the remainder is p of a. Simply substitute a here. That is only the remainder. This is remainder theorem. Factor theorem. So factor theorem, same continuation of that remainder theorem. X minus a is a factor of p of x if p of a is equal to 0. If p of a is equal to 0, automatically x minus a is a factor of p of x. Till now we get a remainder as 3. If that remainder is 0, means p of a is equal to 0, then x minus a is the factor of p of x. Otherwise, if x minus a is the factor of p of x, then we will get p of a is equal to 0. This is vice versa. Here, one example. If x minus 2 is a factor of x square plus ax plus 1, find the value of a. This a value we have to find out. X minus 2 is a factor. Factor means x minus 2 is equal to 0. Then if you transpose that minus 2, that become plus 2. X is equal to plus 2. According to factor theorem, p of x is equal to x square plus ax plus 1. P of x is this. Then p of 2 should is equal to 0. Here this is a factor. X minus 2 is a factor. Then x is equal to 2, then p of 2 should is equal to 0. Then p of 2, I am writing here, p of 2 means except this x we should write 2. 2 square plus a into 2, a into 2 plus 1, that is equal to 0. So 2 square 4 plus a into 2 means 2a plus 1 is equal to 0. Here constant terms, 4 plus 1, 5. 2a plus 5 is equal to 0. 2a, if you transpose this plus 5, become minus 5. Next, a is equal to minus 5. This is 2 into a. If you transpose this 2, it become by 2. A is equal to minus 5 by 2. If they give, they can give problems like this. So simply in exam, if they give like that, simply substitute, except this x, substitute 2, and except that a, they will give options, na? But options you can substitute here. Substitute this x value 2, and they will give options. Option value, whatever they will give, minus 5 by 2, minus 1 by 2, minus 3 by 2. Substitute those options. Then you will get answer easily. So, So till now just we completed just introduction of polynomials. In next video we will continue factorization of polynomials. So thank you for watching. Please share and subscribe my channel.